So, what is it with drugs? What is it with drugs? Look what the cat drugged in. Substance abuse among students is no longer just a health or social problem. It's a learning problem, especially in institutions of higher learning where the student is more and more on his or her own. So, what is it with drugs? Malnutrition. Malnutrition. That was easy, huh? We solved that one. Let's get on to something else. Oh, okay. Malnutrition. Even in developed nations, ignorance causes a form of malnutrition. As if that were bad enough, even with what is known, the body needs also nourishment that is of yet unknown. Obviously, you get the multivitamin pill, you spend like $30 for it. You got it at the optimum health food store. Vitamin A, vitamin C, vitamin D, vitamin E, vitamin P, vitamin K. And it says, plus unknown. No. Science cannot place the unknown in tablet form, folks. Unknown. Okay. As if that were bad enough, you know, even in developed nations, ignorance causes a form of malnutrition. As if that were bad enough, even with what is known, the body needs also nourishment that is, as of yet, unknown. In fact, concerning nutrition, as well as practically everything else, there will always be unknowns. But in a situation of malnutrition, the individual tends to undergo detrimental experience purposely in a knee-jerk reaction to try to replace what's missing in the experience of the nutriated existence. The body produces its own drugs naturally, in proper proportions, and the individual can snap out of it if the external conditions require. This is essential in the learning environment in order for the student to be duly fascinated so that the memory tissue can form. This may be why slum schools are so renowned for disinterested students. In that case, the individual may be disadvantaged, but it can also happen in a school in the upbeat neighborhood where the albeit advantaged student is still subject to what I call micro malnutrition, the result of ignorance, indifference, or just plain unavailability of the necessary unknowns. Look, let's be fair, huh? We all forget. In a situation of specialized labor, when we are away from certain ideal agrarian situations, where we may have had the optimum criterion where the individual is exposed to all the proper ingredients, known and more importantly unknown, of dietary intake, we exist in a depraved environment. We forget, and that's that. No one's that good. No one's that good. In the normal situation where 50 to 80 minerals are there in the water supply and all essential aspects of diet are had without the need for thought or testing, you will find a high incidence of civilization as ancient history has proven. Yet people are scratching their heads and wondering what made them so great when in places like the United States the learning lesson is so poor by comparison. It's in the food, and subsequently, because of the lack thereof, in the resort for the preponderance of individuals to substance abuse to fill the void sensed. We all need to have all the essential nutrients available on a timely basis and made available at the drop of a hat. Furthermore, with easily understood labeling that can be read without reading glasses that constantly remind us, you're going to have to stick the vitamins, minerals, and phytonutrients in the cotton candy. You're going to have to put the tribbles in the quadratriticale. If you want your school to get the federal aid, you're going to have to enforce a free lunch that comes with a vitamin pill and multi-minerals. But it's when the body is malnourished, either through poverty or ignorance, that the individual turns to drugs. Yeah, like, kind of think of it as a form of self-medication gone really perverted. Okay, you may argue that and cite certain examples, but you will find that on a collective basis, when the body is properly nourished and the mind has been properly nutriated throughout its lifetime, that the majority of those individuals are far too preoccupied with the stability of their social and external condition and far too fascinated with learning itself to waste time either with experimentation or with the regular use of drugs. Then that collective brings social pressure and casual surveillance of the masses to bear on the miscreant exception, which usually consists of those who of necessity use drugs as a part of a belief system.